Let's go back and look at that title block situation real quick. Here's another item that comes up. So when I drop in that title block, of course, with block geometry, you can configure it to have attributes. And you'll notice some of these attributes, I can plug stuff in. So say 16th of an inch equals 1 foot. I can type that in. Other items, however, they're kind of grayed out. I can't directly type into them. I can double click and get to what I need to, but these are actually pulling from the drawing fields. And that's something that you can do with any piece of text. It does not have to be necessarily in a block object, but a title block is probably the most common way you're going to use this. So when I say okay, zoom in down here, you'll notice a lot of these fields are kind of highlighted gray. The drawing number, notice it's already got the drawing name in there. There's no title description, there's no drawn by or anything like that. These items are being pulled from the drawing fields. Where do you get those? If you go to the application button, so that's the big A in the upper left, come down to drawing utilities, go to drawing properties. In the drawing properties, these are the fields that you can use. You can populate these pieces of metadata, really, and pull that into your drawing. So title, subject, author, you know, I'm just going to put my initials in here. Comments, we're going to call it the setup drawing. Statistics or custom, you can pull any of that information into your drawing as a field, and you can add your own. That's what these custom ones are. Various materials, alternate materials, maybe say where you buy something from, like a fab shop that's making it, or even an alternate fab shop, vendor, supplier, things like that. You can add whatever you want to add. When I say okay, and I type regen, notice the drawn populates and the title populates. Again, they're pulling from those fields associated with the drawing properties.